Greetings out there, greetings. I'm back again. This is Mr. Mathebula. So our message for today is from the book of John, the book of John 3, verse 16 to 17. The book of John, verse 3, verse 16 to 17. God has kept us saving this day. God has granted us an opportunity to see this particular day. So I am very blessed that you are also present even today, my viewers out there. So my message for today, I will be answering a question. I'll be answering a question that says that, where can I find true love? Where can I find true love? Where my viewers can find true love there? I know that most of us have been confused. We are confused. We are searching love in wrong places. Whereas Jesus is the only place which we can find love from. A safest place where every being can find love from. So I've taken the message from the book of John, the title of the message is Jesus teaches Nicodemus. Let us hear what the word of God tells us. We have John 16. From John 16, it reads as follows: For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Hallelujah out there, people. Meaning we are saved through Jesus Christ. We are saved through Jesus Christ. You remember, if you can remember or recall very well, last week I was preaching about the message which was also taken from the book of John, whereby there I was telling people the right path which we should embark on, which we should go to, which is Jesus. I also outlined there that Jesus is the only a mediator between us and God, meaning we are only saved through God. Let not your pastors or your so-called prophet of God fool you, telling you that they are the one who will save you from your sins. No, my sisters, we are only saved by God. We are only saved by God. Using what? Using Jesus as our mediator. meaning our pastors, as I've already told you even last week, that our pastors were brought for the purpose of ushering us to Jesus, in order for us to do what? In order for us to connect with Jesus, to tell Jesus each and every problem that we have. So Jesus sends the problem to God. God do what? God save us from our sins. Meaning we are saved through the grace of God. We are saved through the grace of God by using what? By using Jesus as our mediator. Meaning Jesus, actually God also has done what? God has loved us by giving what? By offering us a living sacrifice, which is Jesus, for him to die for our sins, for him to die for us, so that whoever believes in God shall not perish but have eternal life. Meaning we are saved. We are saved by God. God has loved us, people out there. God has demonstrated his true love for us by giving his one and only Son, one of the hallmark of true, one of the demonstration of sacrificial love is, one of the demonstration of true love is sacrifice, meaning this love, as we can read from there, as you can read there at verse 16, where it says that, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, meaning giving your only son. It's a sign of it's a sign which demonstrates sacrifice, meaning God has sacrificed there, a sacrifice for me and you to have experience this true love which we are experiencing right now. So I am urging you, my brothers and sisters out there, for you to go to the throne of God, for you to go to the place of God to find happiness there, because there is joy, peace, as well as self-control in the place, in this place of God. So my brothers and sisters, God has granted us an opportunity to understand this word, meaning we are saved by the word of God. God has saved us through Jesus, meaning Jesus is the one which is used by God to save us. Hallelujah out there, my viewers. So let us go and approach the throne of God. I know that most of you have been going to wrong places, trying to find love, but what you find is, but what you receive as a result is heartbreak, the break in your heart. They are only breaking your heart instead of giving you true love, which I am talking about today. Jesus is the only place which we can find love. I know that most of you are now obsessed. Most of you are obsessed with finding your soulmate. We have developed that mentality that thinking, you have developed that mentality that when we have met our soulmate, we will be saved in our spirit. We will be protected. Actually, that will be the happiest moment. That will be the happiest moment of our lives, which we will experience. But I have a word today that tells, that correct the mis, that, that which will correct, which will correct that misconception, which will correct that, which will correct that misconception, that Jesus is the only one we have true love. Don't trust people. People will hurt you. People will break your heart. People will break your heart. Go to Jesus. Jesus is the only one who never break our hearts, but handle our hearts with care. Jesus is the good handler of our hearts. So let us go to him with throne. Let us go to his throne with thanksgiving and praise, because he is the one who deserves to be praised. He is the one who deserves the honor. He's the one who deserves to be loved. He's the one who deserved to be given wholeheartedly our heart. He deserves to be given everything which we have. I mean, we know that everything which is given to God, it is in the safe place. After receiving this love of God, we'll sing this song that say that, in the shadow of your wing, I know I am safe. In the shadow of your wing, I found relief. For you hold me and you guide me. That is the song. You will sing that song. You will sing that song of praise. Because, yeah, in Jesus there is love. There is love, people. Let us go to God. Let us go to Jesus. Let us go to God through Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's go to God through Jesus, receiving to first receive the power which God has placed purposely for our hearts. Because we need, no matter how rich we are, people, no matter how successful we are, we need to be loved. But the question is, where are we seeking our love from? Because Jesus is the only place which have love. And mind you me, no one will love you. No one will love you unless they were. No one will love you unless they experience the love which God has placed into their hearts. What I'm trying to say is that no one which has come in contact with God have love. Those that have come to the place of God are the ones that have love in their spirit, because Jesus has placed that love into their hearts. So my brothers and sisters, let us go to God. Let us go to God, because God is love. God is love. He is love, demonstrated the love for us by giving his one and only son, for him to die for our sins, so that whoever believes in his word shall not perish, but have eternal life. Meaning, we have now experienced, we have now entered into the journey. We have now entered into the journey of going to, of heading to the place where eternal love is, where eternal love locates. So, my brothers and sisters out there, God is love. God is love. I've experienced the love of God. God is love. I know that most of you out there are wondering. You are wondering where can I exactly find true love? Because what I receive from people is only reject. People are rejecting me. They don't want to be part of my cycle. They don't want to walk with me. I know that most of you have been rejected by your parents because of your bad habits, because of your wrong act. But I have Jesus today. Jesus, his love is sacrificial. He was purposely sent to earth for him to die for our sins, for him to die for our transgressions, so that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have this eternal life, which is placed before us people. Most of you, you don't know where your father. You don't know where your father is. You don't know where your father is because your father has denied the pregnancy before you were born or brought into this earth. But I have Jesus today. Jesus, true father. Jesus, who is mother to them, who is a parent to those who have lost hope. My brothers and sisters, don't take that rope and hang yourself. There is someone who loves you, which is Jesus. Jesus loves you. Even if the world can reject you, but always know that Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. He loves you. He loves you, people. So I don't know how do you feel out there about this message? This message is very powerful for my viewers out there. So people, let us go to the Word of God and understand the scriptures, because the scriptures are healing to our souls. Our scriptures heal us during time of distress, because Satan, there are times where we feel like our spirit, where we feel like we are distressed, but the Word of God is the one that lifts, that gives us strength during those times. So be courageous, my brothers and sisters out there. God loves you.